In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet dividing radical expressions. Our directions for this worksheet are to simplify. And when simplifying, we cannot have a radical in the denominator. So when we're dividing, it's going to be all about getting that radical out of the denominator. So in number 1, we're going to focus on getting the square root of 20 out of that denominator. Think about it this way. If we have the square root of x, in order to make that x a whole number, we need to multiply it by the square root of x, because that will be the square root of x times x, which is the square root of x squared. And remember, that radical will cancel out that exponent of 2 to give us the whole number x. So we're going to do those same steps, but for the square root of 20. However, when we're multiplying a fraction, we don't want to change the overall value of the fraction, so we're going to multiply by 1. The square root of 20 over the square root of 20 is equivalent to 1. So if we multiply by the quantity 1, we're not changing this value, but we'll be able to manipulate this square root of 20. So multiplying the numerators, we'll have the square root of 15 times 20 over 5 times the square root of 20 times 20. 15 times 20 is 300, so we'll have the square root of 300 all over 5 times the square root of 20 squared. So you can see that indeed I will be able to pull out that 20 from the radical because it will cancel out. So I'll have the square root of 300 over 5 times 20. However, the square root of 300 can be simplified. If we write 300 as a perfect square multiplied by some other number, the largest perfect square that goes into 300 is 100. We can write 300 as 100 times 3, so that's 10 squared times 3. So I'll have the square root of 10 squared times 3 over 5 times 20, which is 100. So pulling out that 10 within the square root within my numerator, I'll get 10 times the square root of 3 all over 100. However, we can still simplify this fraction because 10 goes into 100 evenly, and that's one time. So we'll have the square root of 3 over 10 as our solution in number 1. And again, I was able to simplify because I divided the numerator by 10 to get 1 and the denominator by 10 to get 10. So the square root of 3 over 10 is our solution in number 1. Let's continue on to number 2. In number 2, lucky enough for us, 100 is a perfect square. So we'll have the square root of 8 over the square root of 10 squared. Because 100 we can write as 10 squared, and the square root of 100, or the square root of 10 squared, is 10. However, we need to simplify the square root of 8. 8 we can write as 4 times 2, which is 2 squared times 2. So if we have the square root of 2 squared times 2, we'll be able to pull out that 2 from the radical in the numerator to get 2 times the square root of 2 over 10. However, 2 divided by 10 when simplified is 1/5. So we'll have 1 times the square root of 2 over 5, which we'll write as the square root of 2 over 5. That's our simplified solution in number 2. Continuing on to number 3, I'll start by multiplying by 1. And that 1 that I'm multiplying by is the square root of 27 over the square root of 27. So I'll have the square root of 6 times 27 over the square root of 27 squared. Because 27 times 27 is 27 squared. So in my denominator, I know that I'll be able to pull out that 27, since the square root will cancel out that exponent of 2. And in the numerator, I'll have the square root of 6 times 27, which is 162. Now I'm going to need to simplify this numerator. 162, the largest perfect square that goes into that number, is 81. 81 times 2 equals 162, and 81 is that largest perfect square of 9 squared. So 9 squared times 2 is equivalent to 162. So I'll rewrite that radical in the numerator as the square root of 9 squared times 2 all over 27. Then I'll be able to pull out that 9. So I'll have 9 times the square root of 2 over 27. However, 9 27ths can be simplified because 9 and 27 are both divisible by 9. So we'll have 1 times the square root of 2, which is the square root of 2, over 27 divided by 9, which is 3. So the square root of 2 over 3 is my solution in number 3. And again, that's because both 9 and 27 are divisible by 9. In number 4, we'll start by multiplying by the square root of 4 over the square root of 4. So essentially multiplying by 1. In our numerator, we'll have 3 times the square root of 20 times 4. And in our denominator, we'll have 2 times the square root of 4 squared. So we'll have 3 times the square root of 20 times 4 is 80 over 2 times 4, because the square root of 4 squared is 4. So now I'm going to need to simplify the square root of 80. 80 can be written as 16 times 5, where 16 is that largest perfect square. So that's 4 squared times 5. So rewriting our numerator as 3 times the square root of 80, but 80 as 4 squared times 5, all over 2 times 4, which is 8. So we'll have 3 times 4 times the square root of 5, divided by 8. So that's 12 times the square root of 5 over 8, but 12 and 8 are both divisible by 4. 4 goes into 12 3 times, and 4 goes into 8 2 times, so we'll have 3 times the square root of 5 all over 2. In number 5, we'll multiply by the square root of 5 over the square root of 5. So we'll get 4 times the square root of 5 over the square root of 5 squared, which is 4 times the square root of 5 over 5. And this cannot be simplified any further, so that's our solution for number 5. Because the square root cancels out that square, so our denominator is 5. In number 6, we'll be multiplying by the square root of 3 over the square root of 3. So we'll get the square root of 4 times 3 over 5 times the square root of 3 squared. Now note that 4 is a perfect square. 4 I can write as 2 squared. So I'm going to have the square root of 2 squared times 3 all over 5 times 3. Since the square root cancels out that square and I can pull out that 3 in the denominator. So the square root of 2 squared is 2, and then I'm multiplying that by the square root of 3, and that's going to be all over 5 times 3, which is 15. And 2 and 15 are not divisible by a common number, therefore 2 times the square root of 3 over 15 is my solution in number 6. In number 7, I'll be multiplying by the square root of 3 over the square root of 3. That will be the square root of 5 times 3 over the square root of 3 squared, which is the square root of 15 over the square root of 3 squared, which is 3. And the square root of 15 cannot be simplified, therefore the square root of 15 over 3 is my solution in number 7. And lastly in this video, we'll go over number 8. In number 8, I'm going to be multiplying by 1, but writing 1 as that radical that's in the denominator in both the numerator and denominator for my value 1. So I'll have the square root of 3 over the square root of 3 multiplied by the square root of 2 over 2 times the square root of 3. So that's going to be the square root of 2 times 3 all over 2 times the square root of 3 squared. So that's the square root of 6, since 2 times 3 is 6, all over or divided by 2 times 3, since the square root of 3 squared is 3. So that's going to be the square root of 6 over 6. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Continue on to the next video, where I'll continue on with this worksheet, completing numbers 9 through 14. And as always, like, subscribe, and share.